Right, so this is a video that I've been waiting to do a while, so welcome to the video. Basically, this is going to be a preview for the fact that we are starting a podcast. It's going to be called the Decade Podcast, the reason of which will be the first thing we talk about on the podcast. The official video, the full video will be released on the channel, which will be on the, what will be, the 17th of February. I will be away in London, so I will set it up to come out at the time. Should be fun. We're not going to be able to do the videos too regularly because obviously we have lives other than just YouTube. But
we have lives.
We have work, basically. That's what I'm saying. So other than that, yeah. So this is going to be the clip I'm going to be playing after this. This is just going to be a preview. And I will see you in the actual podcast. So, hey. The reason it's called Decade Podcast is I have known this guy for 10 years this year. I think I joined the school. I think it was about February 3rd. Oh, let me pause in. I joined the school, I think it was about February 3rd, it's February 4th today when we're recording it, so it's literally 10 years yesterday.
That's mad. That's insane.
Literally, I'm 23 years old, and for 10 years of that, I've known Tom.
Oh, how dare.
And pretty much, and I don't have any pictures anywhere, but I will see if I
can... Thank God!
Tom used to have really long hair and he looked like an absolute hippie, and somehow we became friends. I don't know how.
Look at this moron.
So basically the story of how we met was quite simple. I went through my first lesson where I was quiet, I just didn't speak, I just got on with my work, went into the second lesson, and I think it was Miss Harvey was our math
teacher. I think it was.
Yeah. And she basically said, when I went in, she was like, oh, you go sit next to Tom. So I was like, okay, I'll go sit next to Tom, and literally...
What a mistake.
the first friend I've made at the school was Tom, and we've still been friends ever since, so...
And he's been really wishing he hadn't.
No. We're both just as weird as each other.
Imagine
so
if he sat next to someone else, and this wouldn't be happening right now.
I mean, I think it still would, because we still would have talked.
Yeah, probably, to be fair.
I still would have been friends with some of the other people. Like, I remember on the first day, Sam, shout out to Sam, we did bully him a little bit. Woo-hoo. So, we did bully Sam quite a bit. But he was our friend, on my first day, I remember he was at the bus stop, and I'm sure he wouldn't mind me saying this. If you go onto my channel, my main channel, you will see Sam in some of my videos, and basically he was getting attacked. Someone else was sticking condoms on their hand and waving it in his face. Like, they literally stuck a condom on their arm and started, like, waving it in his face. And I think me and Sam became friends that day. But then he later said...
What a reason. That's such an incredible reason.
But then he later on actually said he tried talking... He was actually in my first lesson, and he tried talking to me, but I blanked him and walked off. He tried talking to me as I walked out, and apparently I just walked off and just went straight to my next lesson. And obviously that's where I met Tom, and it turned out that Tom was friends with Sam anyway, and Sam was friends with David and everybody else.
All mishmashed together.
So no matter what, I was destined to become friends with this buffoon. But
yeah. Well, I mean, I guess, you know, with the way you met Sam, you could say you could have saw it coming.
Oh, that was terrible, Tom. You're giving me migraines. that was 2009, February 2009. I think it was February 3rd, 2009 was my first day at Hewitt. And, of course, we were the best year, because ever since we've left, that's the school's pretty much fallen apart.
Literally, I think they said we were a really good, nice year.
Yeah, like, they always did.
Everyone was pretty whatsoever every year. You're the best year. And then next year, you're the best year.
No, every year they said that we were the best year. Like, all three years, so when we was in year 8, they said we was the best year.
I think we genuinely had some really nice people in our year.
What I would like to do, actually, for this podcast is get some people from school on there, on here, and we can talk about school experiences. That would be cool.
I mean, probably, definitely Big Sam.
Definitely get Sam in one day.
Got to get Big Sam. So Big Sam's got some stories, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
That I've probably forgotten as well.
So then after we left school, we both, well, I did a year of sixth form. We both went to sixth form together. I did a year, failed miserably. I ended up coming away with, I think it was 2 ungradeds and barely a pass in sports. We did the sports BTEC. Our teacher was barely actually present, and I managed to come away just about with a pass. So I then went on to do college, did 2 years of college, and then went on to work, which honestly I've much preferred work over education. It just wasn't for me. Obviously there's a lot of people who love their education, work hard at it. I'm just like, nah. Like when I'm done, this is what I find the best thing. When I'm done with work for the day, that's it. When you're at school, when you're in education, you get homework and it's like, oh, but I need to get this done, I need to get this done. Like, when I'm at work, it's like, no. That's my time.
No more homework.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm glad we don't get homework.
Oh, could you imagine having work and then having homework for work? Nah.